Let's show some important properties of Hermitian operators, and let's start with the fact that the eigenvalues of a Hermitian operator are real. So if we look back at the example of the theta operator from Maxwell's equations, we had that if we had the theta operator operating on our magnetic field, that we got back our magnetic field times omega squared mu. So if you want to make this a bit more general, you could also call omega squared mu lambda, so that this stresses that this is an eigenvalue, but let's focus on this particular example here. And the problem we have is, can we show that this eigenvalue, omega squared mu in this case, is a real number? So to help you with this quest, I suggest what you do is you take this equation here, and you take the scalar product on the left-hand side with the magnetic field. And then you take the complex conjugate of the end result, and then do some manipulations based on what you know about the properties of the scalar product as we have defined it, and also the properties of Hermitian operators. So pause the video and see if you can indeed show that omega squared mu, the eigenvalue, is real. Okay, if we take our equation and then on the left-hand side we take the scalar product with h, we get h theta h for the left-hand side, and then we have omega squared mu, and then h h. Okay, so this is just taking that equation up here, and then both for the left-hand side and the right-hand side, taking the left scalar product with h. Okay, next step, taking the complex conjugates of this whole business, then we have h theta h complex conjugate equal to omega squared mu complex conjugate, so the conjugate of our eigenvalue, and then h with h complex conjugate. But let's now make use of some properties of the scalar product as we have defined it in an earlier video, and then we know that if you have the complex conjugate of the scalar product, that this is the scalar product in the opposite direction. So we exchange the first and the second factor here. So we have theta h h, okay. And then for this guy over here, now you might be tempted to say, okay, non-magnetic media, mu is perhaps one. For physical reasons, the resonance frequency is also real. So therefore we conclude for physical reasons that this guy is real and that therefore the complex conjugate can disappear. But that's precisely what we do not want to do in this video. We want to prove purely from a mathematical point of view that omega squared mu is real without relying on any physics at all. So just to convince the diehard mathematicians that this is really true. So let's just keep this as it is, because this is really related to what we want to show. What we do know is that this norm here, h with h, that's a purely real number. Also see previous videos on the properties of the scalar product. So there we can get rid of the complex conjugate. Right. Let's now take a final step, and that is making use of the fact that our operator is Hermitian, which is of course crucial, and we haven't used that yet. And since our operator is Hermitian, it doesn't really matter when we take the scalar product here, whether we operate on the first or on the second factor. So we can bring that theta from here to there. And if we then copy what we had on the right-hand side, we end up with the following result. But now it becomes interesting, because if you compare what we had up here and what we now have down there, you see that they're basically identical, and the only conclusion there is that if these guys are identical, because their left-hand side is identical, then we need to come to the conclusion that omega mu is equal to omega mu complex conjugate. So therefore, the eigenvalue is indeed a real number, which is what we wanted to show. And if we now move back to the example from Maxwell here, and if we say that we work with non-magnetic media, then this also leads to the fact that the square of the resonance frequency is also a real number. Right. But in general, the eigenvalue of a Hermitian operator is a real number.